Yeah, because, yes. I'm on here. Come on in, OCT. Come on in, OCT. We live. We live. Come on in. Let me know you're out there. I believe my media team got me good to go. So you can chime on and make a comment. So we would love for you to make some comments tonight. We'd love for you to make some comments tonight. Let me know you on here. Let me know who's on here tonight. Hopefully everybody is doing well tonight. Hopefully you're having a good day. It's a little chilly, a little cold. Let me know you're on here. Let me know you're on here. Can you give me water? Yes, 6:20, 10 minutes. And we'll be going. Yes. Yes. Come on in, OCT. Bible study. Got a couple people on here. Come on. Let me know who you are. Don't be shy. Let me know who you are so we can talk a little bit. Let me know you on here so we can say praise the Lord to you, OCT, or whoever you are. Come on here. Let me know you're here. Let me know you're here. Let me know you're here. All right. Hey, how you doing, Sister Holt? Happy belated birthday. Hope you had a great birthday. I had one. Hopefully you had a great birthday. So we are glad you're on. Who else is on here? Let us know you're on here. Let us know you're on here. Let me know who you are. We are excited about tonight, excited about the word on tonight. Can't wait till we get back together. Oh, what a time. What a time that's going to be when we can get together to and fellowship. Let me know who's all on here. Don't be shy. Let me know you're on here. Yeah, let me know you're on here. Yes. Let me know you're on here. Talk to me, OCT. Who's all on here so we can give you a shout out? Yes. Yes. So you might have to mute everybody.
All participants are muted.
Y'all are now. Yes. Yeah. All right. How's everybody doing? All right. The Jacksons. All right. Jacksons is on here. Man. Amen. Who else is on here? Talk to me. Did anybody get a stimulus check today? Did anybody get their check? The Johnsons got their check this morning. Hallelujah. I feel a shout coming on. Come on, somebody. Who else got their check? Who got that check? Who got that check? Check hit my account this morning, y'all. God is good. Who else got that stimulus check? Come on. Don't be shy. Let everybody know you got that blessing. Yes, let us know you got your check. Anybody got that check in the mail? Anybody got that check in deposit? Yes, let us know you got your check. Amen. The Lord is good. Who else is on here? Let me know you're on here. If you don't mind, let me know you're on here. All right. Sanyel and Caleb, how y'all doing? Sanyel's and Brother Caleb is on here tonight. God bless you. Amen. Give me some more thumbs up if you got your check. You got that stimulus check. Give me some thumbs up. Amen. We got ours. So it's not a hoax, y'all. It's real. It is real. Yes, it's real. Amen. All right, they're coming on. The saints are coming on. Come on in. Come on in, saints. Share this. Tell somebody. Text somebody. Tell them to come on. Call somebody. Send somebody the church link, YouTube link. Tell them to come on in. Amen. Amen. Who else is on here? Let me know you're on here. So I know who's on here. Dr. Oliver. All right, Dr. Oliver, Trustee Oliver is on here. God bless you. God bless you. I wish they did the names like they do on Facebook. Wouldn't have to ask who's all on here, but amen. The Dowdells are on here. Come on, that's right. Let's do a roll call, OCT. Man, we got Sister Hope Jackson's, Sister Sanyel, Brother Caleb, Brother Oliver and family, Trustee Oliver, Dowdells. Come on, who else is on here? Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Let us know you're on here. Let me know you got that check. Pastor G got his check today, y'all. Pastor G got his stimulus check today. Somebody shout hallelujah. Got a couple more minutes. Hallelujah. That check hit my bank this morning, y'all. God is good. Amen. Amen. Who else got that check? Don't be shy. Come on. Come on. Let everybody know you got that check so we can call and ask for some money. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on in. Who else is on here? Who else is on here? We're going to start in about one more minute. Amen. We're thankful unto the Lord today. And we believe we got a word from the Lord tonight. And we are excited. Amen. That's right. Amen. That's right, Trustee Oliver. Stimulus time. Stimulus time. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm not going to spend mine, though. I'm going to keep mine. I'm going to save mine. Come on, somebody. I'm going to save mine. Amen. Save it for a rainy day. Amen. Amen. All right. We're going to get going in one more minute. It's 6:30. Amen. And we'll get going maybe about 6:31. Give a couple more people. Call somebody. Share this. Tell somebody to chime on tonight. And we believe in the Lord is going to help us tonight. Amen. Sister Evangelist Jackson says, stimulus me, please. Amen. Y'all ain't got y'all. Y'all's coming. It's coming. Somebody shout, money coming. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, money is coming. Amen. I could be a prophet now, y'all. I could be a true prophet. Money is coming to you in your house. Money is coming to you in your house soon. All right. All right. Amen. We're gonna sing a little bit of I Love You. How many people love the Lord on tonight? Help me sing tonight. Amen. That we love the Lord and that we truly appreciate Him. All right, let's sing. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you cared for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. And that's why my heart is filled with praise. Come on, somebody, help me say it. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today, because you cared for me, hallelujah, in such a special way. Help me sing it. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. And that's why my heart is filled with praise. Come on, lift your hands wherever you at and say, I love you. Glory. I love you. Glory. I love you, Lord, today. Make your home a sanctuary because you care for me. Hallelujah. In such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. And that's why my heart is filled with praise. How many people can say your heart, your mind, your soul? Help me say it. Your heart. And what else? My mind and my soul belongs to you. You paid the price for me. Glory. Way back on Calvary, that's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. One more time. My heart, my mind, my soul, my heart, glory to God, and my mind and my soul belongs to you. Oh, you paid the price for me. Yes, you did. Way back on Calvary, that's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. Hey, that's why my heart is filled with praise. Hey, that's why my heart is filled with praise. Hey, that's why my heart is filled with praise. Come on and give God praise. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody give God praise wherever you at. Come on, open up your mouth and let them know that you love them tonight. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We truly appreciate you, God. We thank you for who you are. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. Come on, people, let's worship him for about 30 more seconds. Come on, we thank you, God. We truly appreciate you for who you are, God. Hallelujah. You are mighty, oh God. God, you are awesome, God. You are wonderful, God. In spite of all that I'm going through, you're still a good God. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord God, for this word that you're going to give us tonight. Father God, we ask you to bless all those that are watching today, those that are on the conference call tonight. We ask you, God, that we're still moving from pain to power, oh God, from pain to victory, from pain to freedom, God, in the name of Jesus. So, Father God, we pray right now for everybody that's here tonight. We ask you to open up our ears, oh God. We ask you to change my thoughts, oh God. We ask you to touch my speech, oh God, that we'll be able to give the people what we believe that you've given us tonight, God, in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you for everybody that's here. We ask you to continue to strengthen the church, continue to strengthen OCT, continue to strengthen those that's watching, oh God, from far and from near. Father God, we strengthen them, strengthen their families, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And so, can we give your name the praise, the glory, and the honor in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We praise the Lord. Everybody, we thank God for you that is here on tonight. We thank you for chiming on tonight. We thank you for those that's listening via conference call. God bless you. We appreciate you for chiming in on the conference call. So we're just so glad tonight to be back in Bible study. Amen. I'm telling you, I'm still full from partaking the Lord's body. Amen. Eating his body and drinking his blood. I am still full on today, and I'm thankful on tonight. Amen. For what God has did. And I believe in God for complete healing. I believe in God that he's going to heal you. He's going to heal your family members. He's going to cover you. Amen. I need you to believe that tonight, that, amen, that no pestilence, no plague, no disease, amen, shall come near you. And I believe if it tries to get a hold of you, I believe in the power of prayer, because he says he gives us power over all sicknesses and over all diseases. So I believe we can pray the prayer of faith, and you will be healed in Jesus' name. So we're thankful on tonight. So we're still dealing with we're going to take our time. I don't know how many more sermons we're going to have or lessons we're going to have on this from pain to power. So we're just going to be led of the Lord, but we're on part three. This is part three of how do we go from pain to power. Step one, we talked about, I'm giving you some steps for those that may be coming on for the first time. I am Pastor Greg Johnson, amen, of Original Christ Temple Church. And we'll thank you for chiming on tonight. And we've been doing a series. We started the series with Don't Settle. And then out of that, we dealt with why do we settle? The root of settling is pain. And then we begin to deal with how do we move from pain to power, from pain to victory, from pain to freedom. So tonight, I want to give you a little recap. Step one to have us to move from pain to power. Step one was the voice of judgment. The voice of judgment must go out of your head. If you're ever going to move from pain to power, from pain to victory, from pain to victory, from pain to 17, that God did not send his son to condemn the world, but to save the world through Jesus Christ. So God did not come to condemn us. So we have to get the voice of judgment out of our head. Step number two was you have to stop believing that outside success is going to heal your inward pain. All right. Step number two was you have to stop believing that outside success, how much money I make, what type of job I've got, how many degrees I've had, what type of house, what type of car I drive. Outside success do not heal you from inner pain. Inward dealing brings inward healing. Let me say that again. Inward dealing brings inward healing. Once you deal with what's on the inside of you, once you deal with what's going on with you inwardly, then you can begin to heal. And your success is not predicated on outside or material things, but your success is predicated on who God has made and designed you to be. All right. So tonight we want to give you another step that we believe is going to help you to have power, live a victorious life, and to walk in freedom. All right. Those who are taking notes, get your pen and paper, please. This word may not be for you tonight, but it could be for somebody you know. Amen. It could be for a family member. It could be for a loved one. So we want you to share this information. Amen. Tell somebody to chime on. If you know somebody that's dealing with pain, dealing with hurt, I believe the Lord has given us a word on tonight. All right. So step number three, amen, to move from power to pain, to victory, to freedom, you must acknowledge and identify what's causing the pain to still be prevalent and present in your life. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. To move from power to pain, to victory, to freedom, we must acknowledge and identify what's causing the pain to still be prevalent and present in my life. What is causing me to still deal with this pain? What is still causing me to still relive the pain? What's causing me to still go back to the past, what she did or what he did or what she said or what he said or whatever they did? What is causing us to still relive, and why is the pain still prevalent in our lives? We must acknowledge our pain. Let me say that again. We must acknowledge it and not live in denial or suppress our true hurt and pain. Hallelujah. We must acknowledge and don't live in denial. Stop saying that you're over it and you're really not. Stop saying that you don't care and you really do. Amen. Acknowledge the pain and do not live in denial and suppressed your true pain and your true hurt. Amen. Because most times we don't want to deal with our pain or deal with discomfort. We rather choose to bury it. Amen. And we try to bury it and still carry all that pain and carry all that anger that has been built up in us. So it is okay. Hallelujah. It is okay to acknowledge I was hurt. Hallelujah. It is okay to acknowledge I am angry. Hallelujah. It is okay to acknowledge I'm still mad. Come on, somebody. I feel the Holy Ghost. I know I'm talking to somebody. I'm still upset that that happened to me. Acknowledge it, the Lord said. Acknowledge it, the Lord said. Acknowledge it. Do not bury it, but acknowledge that I'm still mad and bitter. Acknowledge I'm still hurt and angry. Acknowledge I need closure. I need closure with that person and with that situation. Acknowledge I'm afraid to let go of this pain and hurt and live a new life. Come on, somebody. Acknowledge that you need some closure. You need to get with that person, and you need to have a heart to heart with them. Amen. You need to know that I need to come to grips with this situation, and I need to be able to face that person, talk to them. If they're not even here, if they're no longer here with us, even go to a counselor and do a chair therapy and get it off your chest. You need to acknowledge it. Amen. You need to acknowledge it. Amen. And once you acknowledge, how do you acknowledge your hurt and your pain? You don't have to go here yet. Hebrews 4:16 says, let us therefore go boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace in the time of need. Hallelujah. That's how you acknowledge it. You acknowledge it by taking this pain and taking this hurt to the throne of grace, to the throne of God, and telling him that I am still hurt. Hallelujah. I am still angry. He already knows. He already knows why you're shouting and speaking in tongues. He still knows you're still holding on to it. He still knows that it's still bothering you. So he said, come boldly to the throne of grace. Amen. And get help in the time of need. Amen. So you can acknowledge and let him know how you are truly free, feeling. Amen. Amen. Please take this down. Hallelujah. Acknowledging your hurt feelings is not a sign of weakness. Hallelujah. Who am I talking to? I hope somebody can put that up there and say amen to that. Acknowledging your hurt feelings is not a sign of weakness. It does not mean you are giving into them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It does not mean that you are giving into them. Let me say that again. Acknowledging your hurt feelings is not a sign that you are weak. The devil is a lie. We all have emotions. God has emotions. God gave us emotions. God gave us feelings. Amen. It's not a sign that you are weak. And it doesn't mean that you are given into them. Let those tears flow. Hallelujah. Let those tears flow at nighttime. Let those tears flow in your prayer closet. Amen. Let God know that you are hurt. Amen. Let God know that you are hurt is not a sign that you are weak. Indeed, the process of acknowledging your feelings and working through them will leave you more confident. I'm trying to tell you, and will have you to have a victorious life. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. Instead of you being weak, when you acknowledge your feelings and you work through them, you will leave feeling confident and victorious. Amen. You become free. You will have more freedom than you ever had. And you're no longer lugging and toting around baggage of buried emotions. Amen. Let me say that again. Amen. When you release it and you work through it and you talk through it and you express it, amen, you're no longer lugging around that baggage of those buried emotions. Hallelujah. You are letting it go. Hallelujah. You are becoming a free woman. You are becoming a free man. So the devil is a lie when he's trying to tell you to suppress your emotions, to suppress your feelings. He wants you to live in bondage. He wants you to be in bondage. But the devil is a lie. The Lord wants to set us free tonight. Hallelujah. He wants to set you free tonight. Amen. From hurt and from pain. Amen. Satan doesn't want you to be free. He wants you to carry your pain. He wants you to carry your hurt. Satan does. He wants you to be unhappy. Satan wants you to be bitter. Come on, can somebody put on there bitter? Amen. Satan wants you to be unhappy and he wants you to be bitter. Amen. But the devil is a lie. Hallelujah. God said what? To lay aside what? Every weight and every sin that what? That so easily beset us. Amen. So what? So why? So we can run this race with patience. You cannot run this race with patience when you're holding on to bitterness and anger. Hallelujah. You're going to always find something to complain about. You're not going to run this race with patience when you are holding on to bitterness and anger, hurt, pain. Hallelujah. Amen. God wants you to lay it aside. He said he wants you to lay aside, amen, every weight that stops us from being who he has called us to be. Hallelujah. All right, so we talked about our first step was acknowledging and identifying. So let's go to the identifying part. Why is it so important for us to acknowledge and to identify? Identifying is so important to our coming out. Amen. It is so important to our coming out of this. We have to identify why we're still holding on to our pain and our hurt. Amen. Amen. Please take this down. Hallelujah. Please, this is the nugget you want to have in your notes. Amen. Amen. Why identifying is so important. Identifying is so important because we can change our lives and behavior once we identify the root that sparks the behavior. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Let me say that again. We can change, or you can change your life or your behavior once you can identify the root that sparks the behavior. Amen. Once you can identify why we keep holding on to our past, why we keep holding on to our hurt and our pain, then you will know what to pray for. Hallelujah. The reason why it's important to identify, because the Bible says what? Sometimes we know not what to pray for. But when God shows you and he lets you know what is the root of your behavior, what sparks your behavior, then you can go to God in prayer. Amen. You can take all of these roots. You can take all of these issues to God in prayer and ask God to create in you a clean heart and help you to renew the right spirit. This is why it's so important to identify. Let me say that one more time. Amen. Identifying is important because you can change your life or your behavior once you identify the root. The key word is the root. Why you do what you do. What causes you to do what you do. What are your triggers? Amen. What sparks? Amen. Amen. What gets to you? What gets under your skin? And why it gets under your skin. Once you identify that root, then you can change your behavior. Hallelujah. We can change our lives. We can change our attitudes. We can change our actions once we know what to take to God and say, God, I need your help. Paul said, amen, the things that I wanted to do, I don't do. Amen, amen. The things that I don't want to do, that's what I do. Hallelujah. But he said what? Oh, wretched man that I am. Hallelujah. He acknowledged that he was wretched. He said, oh, wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body, from this death? Hallelujah. But he said, but thanks be unto God. Amen. It's through Jesus Christ. You have to be open to identify and be able to be transparent with God to say, Lord, I am nothing. I am wretched. I need your help. Amen. Amen. So once you find, amen, once, amen, you find that spark or that root, amen, then you can take it to God in prayer. Hallelujah. Amen. Also, once you identify what is that hurt and what is that root, please take this down. Amen. Amen. To find your hurt, to find the root of your hurt and the root of your pain. Amen. Make a list, hallelujah, of every major hurt that you have had in your life. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Somebody give me some thumbs up. Come on, somebody. Somebody say amen. I want for you to find your hurt. If you don't know why you're still bitter, if you don't know why you're still angry, why you fly off the handle, why you're still frustrated, why you have jealousy. Oh, yes, sir. Come on, sanctified saints. Oh, yeah. Jealousy, envy. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Come on. If you want to know why you operate in that, make you a list of every major hurt that you have had in your life. Write down the times that you've been hurt and the times that you've been angry. List the setbacks of all your difficult times that you have experienced throughout your life. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. For you to find your hurt, hallelujah, make a list of every. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Be transparent. Before you can trust God, you got to be honest. Write down every list. Write down every major hurt on the list that you have had in your life. Write it down. The times. Amen. Some of us know the date. Hallelujah. Some of us even know the time. It was 2:00 in the afternoon when he said that to me. Come on, somebody. It was 3:00 in the morning when she texted me that. Come on. We know the date and the times. Amen. Amen. The month and everything and the year that you have been hurt and you've been angry. List the setbacks of all your difficult times you have experienced. And these are the hurts. Please, I need you to listen. These are the hurts that run your life. Ooh, I feel the Holy Ghost. I know you feel it because I feel it over here. Hallelujah. That list is what runs your life. Hallelujah. That list is what controls your life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That list is what controls you. That list is what runs your life. And that's why you have not moved from the power to from pain to power, from pain to victory, from pain to freedom, is because you have not truly dealt with those things. And we're going to give you the antidote to be able to overcome this. Amen. Tonight. Hallelujah. So write down all your hurts. Write down all your setbacks in your life. Amen. Write them all down. And you would determine and you would know that these are the hurts that run my life. Come on. Come on. Can I get some transparent people to say amen to me tonight? Come on. Can somebody get some thumbs up? Amen. If you've been bitter and maybe you're now on the other side, you're on the good side, but you know at that time when you was bitter, that bitterness run your life. It ruled your life. It controlled your life. Come on, somebody, be transparent and put amen on there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And as you write down, I need you to hear this, people of God. As you write down all your hurts and you write down all your setbacks in you that you have in life, you will discover, boy, God gave me this, y'all. God gave me this. You will discover that I am a hoarder. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, you are. Oh, yes, you are. I know you watched the show Hoarders on TV, and some of us talked about those people. Hallelujah. Some of us talked about those hoarders. Come on, somebody. And we couldn't understand, and we're like, they ought to be ashamed of themselves. You were in that boat. You just didn't collect items and things, but you collect mental things in your head. Come on, somebody. Come on. You will discover I am a hoarder mentally. Hallelujah. Yes, you are a hoarder. Let me give you a definition of what a hoarder is mentally. Amen. What a mental hoarder is. For you that's taking notes. Amen. A mental hoarder is a person that stores massive information or facts retained for the future use. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. A mental hoarder is someone who stores massive information and facts to retain for future use. It's a reserve in the mind for future use. Come on, somebody. That's what a mental hoarder is. They store it in their head. They store it in their mind and they file it. And anything that looks like their past, anything that resembles their past, they use it to get that person off of them. They use it to run away. They use it to hide. They use it to protect them. They use it for future use. Hallelujah. Yes. You are mentally hoarding. You are a hoarding person that hoards mentally. Hallelujah. How many times you said in your mind, okay, they got me on that one. Oh, come on, somebody. I know I'm coming down somebody's street. Come on. How many times you said that? Come on. You know what the old saying is? They get you once. Come on. Somebody type that for me. They get you once. Amen. Shame on who? Hallelujah. Shame on them. But if they get me twice, what? Shame on who? Come on. You know you said that. You are hoarding mentally. Amen. I know you said amen. I never allowed them to do that again. Come on, somebody. I know you said I would never be treated like that again. Come on. I would never do this again. I would never do that again. If you have used those words, you are mentally hoarding. You are mentally hoarding. Hallelujah. And you cannot move from pain to power, to pain to victory, or pain to freedom if you always mentally hoarding. Come on, somebody. Come on. A hoarder is a person that do not want to let go of stuff. Hallelujah. Come on. A hoarder is someone who do not want to let go of things because they have control over the narrative. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. A hoarder, amen, mentally or physically, they do not want to let go of things is because it makes them feel like they have control. I now control my destiny. Now I control who hurts me. Now I control who walks out on me. Come on, somebody. Now I control who uses me. Oh, Lord, I'm coming down somebody's street tonight. Hallelujah. Yes, we have said that we are mental hoarders. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please take this down. Hallelujah. They feel they have control of their outcome. But look what God gave me. Come on, y'all. I'm trying to tell you, this is fresh from the Lord. This is revelation from the Lord. Look what God gave me. Please take this down. Are you taking notes? You want to take this down because you maybe can use this. And I'm telling you, please take it down. Just came straight from heaven today. He said, when you feel the need to be in control, you are really out of control. Hallelujah. I'm telling you what the Lord told me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, when you feel the need, and the key word is need. When you feel the need to be in control, he said, you are really out of control. Come on, somebody. I wish somebody say amen to that. Come on, don't get quiet. Come on, come on, come on, y'all. Don't get quiet out there. I feel you in the spirit realm. Come on, don't get quiet. When you feel the need to have to control everything, you're not in control. You're no longer. Why? Because you're no longer allowing God to be God. Hallelujah. You are trying to be something that you're not supposed to be. Hallelujah. When you try to be in control, you are no longer allowing God to be in control. You are being something that you are not supposed to be. And that's what brings on stress. That what brings on anxiety. That what brings on panic attacks. It's because we're trying to control. We're trying to be God. And it's not designed for us to be God. Hallelujah. We got to let go of that pain. We got to let go of the hurt. Mentally, we got to let it go. Mentally, you are hoarding. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're no longer allowing God to be God. Amen. So we hold on to hurt. Amen. We hold on to hurt and we hold on to pain because we feel that we had no choice in receiving it. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. Hallelujah. We hold on to things and we hold on to pain and we hold on to the hurt. Hallelujah. Because we feel that we had no choice in receiving it. So since I got hurt, I'm going to keep this hurt. Come on, somebody. Ooh, I know I'm talking to somebody. Hallelujah. Since I had to take this pain, then I'm going to keep it so I never have it again. So I never opened up my heart to nobody else. I never trust nobody else. So we hold on to that because we feel like we didn't have no choice in receiving it. Amen. So I will decide. Come on. I know you said this because the Lord told me. So you say, I will decide when I will let it go. Woo! I feel in the spirit. How many people have said, I will decide when I will not be mad at you? Come on. Come on. Come on. How many times you done told your spouse that? When they've tried to come and tell you, I'm sorry and stop being mad at me. How many times you looked at him and told him, I will decide when I would be over this. You don't make that decision for me. Oh, come on, somebody. I know I'm telling the truth. Come on. How many times you told your friend that? Your supervisor that? Come on. A family member that no, I'm not going to let it go. I will choose when I will be over this. Because you're hoarding. Hallelujah. You are hoarding mentally. Come on, I'm telling you, I knew that this was going to touch somebody today. Amen. So this is what the Lord showed me, amen, about hoarding. We're still on hoarding a little bit. So when we try to take things from a person or a person that hoards mentally, who collects things in their mind, they get protective and angry. Let me say that again. When we try to take, the key word, when we try to take things from a person who is a hoarder and who collects things, they get protective and angry. I'm going to let you know why they get angry and protective. This is straight from heaven. Come on, somebody. Somebody say amen on here. Come on. If this word is helping you or you know it's going to help somebody else. Hallelujah. Amen. So when we try to take things from that person who's collecting things, they get protective protective and they get angry because you are reminding them of what they had no control over in receiving the hurt and pain of their past. Woo! Wow. The reason why they get angry and the reason why they get protective is because you are reminding them of what they had no control over in receiving the hurt and the pain. So when you try to tell them to get over it, when you try to tell them to move on, you are taking their hurt from them and is reminding them of what they had to take or what they had to, what they took from you. Hallelujah. So they get protective because you are forcing them again. When you tell somebody to get over it, you're forcing them to take something. You're forcing them to feel like their feelings don't matter. Hallelujah. So be careful. Please, please, all these counselors, wannabe counselors that's watching. Amen. If you haven't went to school, go to school for counseling. Be careful how you try to help people to move forward. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Spirit. I'm telling you, this is what the Lord told me. Amen. Be careful how you try to help people to move forward. Amen. Try not to use, don't use words like just get over it. Woo. Lord have mercy. Just let it go. Come on. Stay away from those words. Can I get an amen to that? Come on. Stay away from words like just get over it. That is stabbing them. That is digging. Then you're putting a knife in them and you're turning it on them when you say that. Amen. Be careful when you use the words like just get over it or just let it go with no compassion. Hallelujah. Ooh, I feel the Holy Ghost. I'm telling you, I knew this was going to be fire tonight because the Lord gave it to me. Hallelujah. He said, be careful. Amen. How you do that? Because it makes them dig their heels in, he said, even the more. Amen. Because you're taking their feelings away and they hurt. Come on, somebody. This is what the Lord said. Be careful by saying, get over it. Get over it. Get over it. Don't worry about that. Because he said, you're making them dig their heels in the more because you're taking away how they feel and you're trying to take away their hurt and they're not ready to release it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When I counsel people and the Lord tells me that they're not ready to let certain things go, I leave them alone. Hallelujah. And I just say, I just listen because he said they're not ready to release it. Boy, I feel the Holy Spirit in this place tonight. They're not ready. So he said, leave them alone and just listen. So sometimes when people come to you with their hurts and they come to you with their pains, it's not for you to preach to them. Come on. Can I get an amen to that? Come on. It's not time for you to give them scriptures. Come on, somebody. I could get some more amens to that. Come on. When you are pouring out your heart or somebody's pouring out their heart to you, the last thing you need a lot of times is a bunch of scriptures. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says do what? To be what? To be what? Slow to what? Slow to speak. Come on. And swift to what? Listen. Come on, somebody. Come on. So that's not what they need at that time. Amen. We all hoard. We are all hoarders of some sort. Some of us hoard physical things. Some of us hoard mental and emotional things. Amen. But God does not want to take your pain. Let me please take this down. God does not want to take your pain or your hurt. He wants you to give it to him freely. Hallelujah. He doesn't want to take, amen, your pain from you. He doesn't want to force the pain away. Amen. He wants you to know it is your choice. It's up to you. if you want to give it to him. He said, I'm just standing at the door knocking. If you don't let him in, he's not going to knock down the door. He just politely knock. So he does not want to just take your pain. He wants you to know that it is your choice to stay in the hurt. Or stay in the pain. Or do you want to move to a better life? Amen. This is why he says in Matthew chapter number 11, 28 through 30, he said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. But the key words, he said, you come. He don't want to force you, but he said, you make a decision that I'm coming to you, God. And he said, when you come to me, he said, I will give you rest. He said, then you can take his yoke upon you and learn of me. But you have to take it. Hallelujah. For I'm meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Amen. So let's get down to the, I only got about 10 more minutes. Give me 10 more minutes. Let's get down to the meat of this. So once we have acknowledged, once we have identified the root of holding on to our pain and to our hurt, what is next? What's next? This is what you need to really listen in on. This is going to bless you. After you have acknowledged, after you have identified, after you know, okay, I'm hoarding mentally, he said, what's next? Let's go to Proverbs. I want you to go to Proverbs chapter number 3, verse 5 and 6. Give you some time to get there. Proverbs, when you got it, if you don't mind, type in I got it. Amen. Yes. If you don't mind, those that's on here, let me know you're on here. Type in, if you got Proverbs chapter number 3, verse 5 and 6. This blessed me today. Hallelujah. It blessed me today. Amen. It blessed me today. Amen. Let me know you're there. Type in, I'm there. Proverbs chapter number 3, verse 5 and 6. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It says what? Trust in the Lord with what? With all in thy heart and what? And lean not to what? Thy own understanding. What? In all your ways do what? Acknowledge. Come on, we're back to that word. Acknowledge him and he's going to do what? And he shall direct your path. I'm telling you, come on, somebody. Come on, I feel the Holy Ghost. Come on, I feel the Holy Spirit all over me. This is what the Lord gave me. What I just said, I did all that backdrop for this scripture. He said, for you, once you have acknowledged and once you have identified what your root issues is, he said, the only way, glory to God, the only way you're going to get through this, you got to trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. You got to trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Hallelujah. That is the first and that's the great commandment. Hallelujah. To love the Lord with what? With all of your heart, with all of your mind, and all of your soul, and with all of your strength. He said, this is the first commandment. So we're back at Proverbs. If you're going to get through your pain and move to power, to victory, and to freedom, he said, you got to trust me. Amen. He said, come on, I hope you're taking this down. He said, the reason we hold and don't let go, because there is a trust issue with God. Woo-wee! Hallelujah. I know God is speaking in this place tonight. He said, the reason you hold on mentally, amen, you hoard mentally and you don't let go, there is a trust issue with God. Now, don't get mad at me. Amen. I'm just the mailman. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. He the one sent this word. So don't get mad at me. Hallelujah. He said, you have a trust issue with God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. The reason we don't let go. Amen. There is a trust issue. Amen. We have to trust God. Hey, please take this down. We have to trust that God is not going to hurt us like man or woman did, like a man or how that woman did. And he wants to use your pain to help somebody. Hallelujah. We must trust that God is not going to hurt us like man or like woman, but he wants us to know he wants to use our pain to help somebody. He wants to use our pain to help somebody tonight. Amen. He wants to use your hurt. He wants to use your disappointment. He wants to use you to help somebody get through just like he brought you through. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He's brought you through. The devil is a lie because you're still here. You're still watching. You're on this YouTube channel. He brought you through. You're not in the crazy house. Come on, somebody. You're not in the hospital. So the devil is a lie. You're still here. You've been worrying. You worried yesterday about today. And today, God got you through today. Come on, somebody. You worried last week about this week. And the Lord has got you all the way through Wednesday so far. So he has brought you through. And he wants to use you just like he brought you through your pain. He brought you through your hurt. He wants to use you to help somebody else. And he wants you to know he is not a man. He's not a woman that he shall lie. Hallelujah. Amen. God has brought you this far. And he wants you to willingly give your hurt and your pain to him. Hallelujah. So that was trust in the Lord with all the heart. The next part says, lean not to your own understanding or your own intellect. Stop being Mr. Gadget. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Stop leaning to your own understanding. Stop leaning to your own reasoning. Stop trying to investigate everything. Hallelujah. He said, lean not to your own understanding or to your own intellect. Stop leaning on what you believe was the reason why you had to go through that horrible experience. Hallelujah. I know I'm talking good in this place tonight. He said, stop leaning on what you believe was the reason why you had to go through that horrible experience. Stop trying to figure out why we having to go through this COVID-19. I feel the Holy Ghost. Woo! Hallelujah. Lean not to your own understanding. Lean not to your own intellect. Why? Please take this down. Isaiah 55 verses 8 and 9 says, for my thoughts are not your thoughts. My ways are not your ways, saith the Lord. For the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Wow. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Stop leaning to your own understanding. Hallelujah. But he said, my thoughts are not your thoughts. Stop trying to figure out why we're going through this. And just say, Lord, I trust you. Woo! Come on, somebody. Lord, I believe that you're going to supply all of my needs. God, I believe you're going to keep me and my household from being sick. Hallelujah. And like I said, and if the devil try to touch us, I believe you will heal and deliver and set free. Stop trying to lean to your own understanding. You are not smarter than God. Somebody type that in for me. We're not smarter than God. Come on, somebody. Somebody type that in for me. Come on, Sister Letha. Somebody, Stephanie. Somebody type that in. We are not smarter than God. Hallelujah. Stop. He told me to tell you, stop listening to unhealthy people. Woo! That's a big one. Hallelujah. He said, stop listening to unhealthy. See, that's the key word. Unhealthy people. Hallelujah. People whose mind is defiled. Hallelujah. People who are bitter. People who are angry. Why would you get counsel from people that are bitter? Hallelujah. Why would you get counsel from people that are angry? Hallelujah. He said, stop listening to unwise counsel. Hallelujah. We're not smarter than God. Hallelujah. Stop listening to unwise counsel. Hallelujah. Stop listening. Get you some wise counselors. Get you some wise people that are wise. Hallelujah. That's full of the Holy Ghost. That's full of the Spirit. And that's going to tell you the truth. Hallelujah. That's not going to agree with your mess. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But they're going to tell you the truth. They're going to tell you what you must do to be saved. Hallelujah. Tell you how to repent. Come on. Have to be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on. Have to have the Holy Spirit. Have to live right. Come on, somebody. Have to love right. He says, stop listening to unwise counsel. The last part of that, it says, but in all their ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. Hallelujah. In all your ways. See, we only want to acknowledge him in some of our ways. Hallelujah. We only want to listen to him. We only want to listen, amen, to God when we agree with God. Let me say that again. We only want to agree with God. We only want to listen to God, I mean, when we agree with him. But let him tell us to do something that we don't agree with. Woo! Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Spirit, y'all. I feel the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Let God tell us something that we don't agree with. Hallelujah. We won't do it. But you've been listening. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost. You've been listening to the White House. You've been listening to Dr. Fiji, whatever his name is, telling you to stay home, telling you to wash your hands, telling you to put a mask on. Come on, somebody. We walk around with masks, gloves on. Why? Because man told us. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost. Man told us to do it. But let God tell us to do something. We won't do what God tells us to do. But man tell us? You wearing your gloves? You wearing your mask? You sanitizing your hands? But as soon as God tells you to do something, you don't do it. Now, the devil is a lie. Ooh, I feel God. I feel like shouting. God said, whose report are you going to believe? Whose report are you going to believe? Your pastor will ask you to do some things. God will ask you to do some things. You won't listen. But as soon as the White House, as soon as the governor, the mayor, don't care nothing about you now. They don't care nothing about you. Don't care nothing about you. As soon as they tell you, stay home, beware, put on a mask, you line up. But when it comes to the word of God, or comes to the man or the woman of God that's watching for your souls, you fight against it. Hallelujah. Let me move on because it's getting quiet out there. Let me move on. It says, in all your ways, acknowledge me, and he will direct your path. Amen. Acknowledge the Lord. How do you acknowledge the Lord? You say, Lord, what's going on with me? Amen. What's causing me to acknowledge? I mean, what's causing me to hold on to this pain? What's causing me to hold on to this hurt? What's hindering my relationship with you? What's hindering my relationship with great people you placed in my life? He wants you to acknowledge him. Acknowledge. What does the word acknowledge mean? To recognize him. To respect him, to notice him, to talk to him, to ask him questions. Hallelujah. He wants you to acknowledge him. Let me read that again. Acknowledge means to recognize him. It means to respect him, to notice him, to him. Ask them questions. That's what we need to do. He said, acknowledge me in all of your ways. Hallelujah. The other day, I was taking my son, who was going somewhere, was going to the store or something. And I asked the Lord, Lord, would I come to the end of my street? Which way you want me to go, left or right? Hallelujah. And I even told my son that. I said, son, the Lord told me to go left. Because we could go to the same store. We could get there going left or right. But I'm living my life. I want to live my life every day to the point that, Lord, what direction you want me to go? He said, go left. I don't know what happened. I don't know what he kept me from. It's not for me to know. He told me to go left. Hallelujah. In all of your ways, acknowledge him. Stop leaning to your understanding. He said, but acknowledge me. And then after that, he said, I will direct your path. Hallelujah. Once you acknowledge him, he will tell you how to get out of this pain. He will tell you how to get out of this hurt. He will tell you how to get out of this bitterness. He will tell you how to get out of this anger. He will tell you how to get out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He'll teach you. He will direct you how to let go. Hallelujah. See the key words. He will teach you how to let go. He ain't going to take it. He will teach you how to let go. And he will direct us. He will direct you how to forgive. I'm not going to talk about that. I may talk about that a little later. But he will teach you and direct you how to forgive and let go. Amen. Please, please take this down. And we almost do. I got like 2 more minutes. Amen. About 2 or 3 more minutes. Give me about two more minutes. 2 or 3 more minutes. He said, amen. He said, you have to let go of the hot stove. Hallelujah. He said, you have to let go of the hot stove. He said, holding on to pain and hurt is like holding on or putting your hand on a hot stove and letting it burn. He said, but instead of it's burning the outside, it's burning your inside. It's burning your emotions. It's burning your peace. It's burning your joy. He said, holding on to pain and hurt. Bitterness, anger. Holding on to that, he said, it's like holding your hand onto a hot stove and letting it burn. Who would do that in their right mind? In their right mind, who would do that knowing their hand has been burnt, their hand is on fire, but they still hold it? So it's the same. Who would do that mentally or inwardly? Holding on to pain that's burning your insides, that's burning that peace up, that's burning that joy, that's burning that happiness up. He said he will direct you to the right people. Let me say that again. God, be open. You got to let go of bitterness and hurt and not trusting people. You got to let that go because he will direct you to the right people. You got to trust that. He will direct you to the right church. Yes, somebody on here that don't have a church home, the Lord will direct you to the right church. He will direct you to the right pastor. He will direct you to the right job, the right career. And when you trust and you acknowledge him, he will direct. If, in my closing, if we're going to get to the other side, if we're going to get to the other side and get through this pain and get through this hurt and let go of that bitterness, let go of that malice, anger, envy, jealousy, come on, and have love and have love and have faith and peace and joy and happiness. He said, we have to trust him with all of our heart. We have to trust him. We have to trust God with our lives. We have to trust God with our relationships. We have to trust him with our marriage. We have to trust him with our children. We even have to trust him with leadership. Hallelujah. We have to trust God. If you're going to move from pain to power, you have to acknowledge and you have to identify the root of why you're holding. Then once you work through all of that, then you go to Proverbs chapter number 3, verse 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. And in all your ways, acknowledge him and he will, hallelujah, direct your path. Somebody lift your hands right now in this place. Come on, come on, come on. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout, I'm ready to be free. Come on, come on. Somebody type on there if you're ready to be free. Type on there, I'm ready to be free. Come on, don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Come on, come on. Somebody type on there, I'm ready to be free. Come on, come on, come on. I'm going to type it if you don't. Hallelujah, I'm going to type it. I'm ready to be. Come on, somebody type it with me. Don't be ashamed. Hallelujah, I just typed it. Hallelujah. I'm ready to be free. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Just because I'm the pastor doesn't mean he don't fight my mind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't think that he doesn't come against me too. I'm ready to be free. Hallelujah. From people. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. I wish somebody had somebody else. Hallelujah. Wish somebody else to put on there. I'm ready to be free. Don't be ashamed. Pastor, I was the first one to put it on there. Come on, somebody. I was the first one to put it on there. Don't be ashamed. Type it. Life and death is in the power of your tongue. As you typing it, you saying it. I'm ready to be free. Come on. I'm ready to be free. Hallelujah. Somebody give God praise for this powerful word. Hallelujah. I am so excited about what God gave me today. I'm telling you, God is a good God, and I am excited about what he's doing for OCT and what he's doing for us. We miss you. Amen. We thank God for everybody that is chiming on, that's here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pastor G, amen. Somebody, they still typing, I'm ready to be free. Come on. Come on. Can we get a couple more people put on there? I'm ready to be free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many people got those checks today? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I told somebody, y'all leave my president alone. Hallelujah. Y'all leave my president alone. Hallelujah. Come on. That's right, sis. You ready to be free. Come on. How many people got those checks? Hallelujah. Y'all leave my president alone. Hallelujah. But we thank God for you and you. This word, I'm telling you, it's gonna be with you. It's gonna stick with you all week. Why? It didn't come from me. It came from heaven. Hallelujah. It came from the Lord. All right, offering time. Come on, offering time. And as you getting, I'm cash apping. If you want to cash app the church, you can cash app the church at hashtag GOCTC. Amen. Somebody type that in for me. Somebody type in our cash app. Amen. Somebody type in our cash app name. Amen. Hashtag GOCTC. Amen. It's offering time. Amen. It's offering time. Let's be a blessing. Amen. And we got a couple of announcements after we do this. Amen. So hang with me about a couple more minutes. You ain't doing nothing. You've been sitting at home all day anyway. Amen. So you got nothing else to do but look at me. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You want to come over here, First Lady? Come on. You don't want to come over here so people can see you? Come on, baby. Come on. Come on. Somebody say, type in, I want to see First Lady. If y'all want to see my wife, come on. I'm trying to get her to come and sit over here by me. If you want to see First Lady, type in, I want to see First Lady. Come on. Come on. Come on. Somebody put in, I want to see First Lady. First Lady. First Lady. First Lady. First Lady. Come on. Somebody type in, I want to see First Lady. Hallelujah. So she'll come and sit by me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody type in, I want to see my First Lady. Yeah, they do. Come on. They typing it in. Come on. Come on. They typing it in. Come on. Somebody type it. Somebody else type in, I want to see my First Lady. They type it in, baby. Come on. Come on. Come on. Amen. They saying, come on, First Lady. Your sister on here. I see you. I see my sister, Tanae. That's my friend, Tanae. That's my girl. Hallelujah. Tanae's on here. Hallelujah. Here's your sister. Here's your sister, Tanae. Come on. Here she go, y'all. Yes! First Lady is here. You want to say something to the people? Come on, baby. Say something.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Love you all and miss you all in Jesus' name.
Amen. That's all. Come on. I know you got a word from the Lord. Come on. Come on. Come on.
No, I'm not ready. God bless everybody.
Amen.
Thank you all.
Amen. So don't forget, you can call your trustee and call your deacon if you want to. People are speaking to you, babe. So Tanae's speaking to you. Jerry's Dr. Oliver. Amen.
Hey.
Amen. Come on, Stephanie. Oh, see the name's coming right there. Amen. Amen. Don't forget, let's give you these announcements. And y'all can send the First Lady some love. Amen. Don't forget to continue to pray for Mother Johnson, my mom, in the loss of her brother. Bishop Johnson, my dad, in the loss of his sister. Please remember them. Continue to remember anybody, family members that you may know that's dealing with this COVID-19. Pray for them. Amen. Please, please, please. Are you getting some love, babe? Get some love. Please pray for their families. Don't forget that this week, this month is Youth Pastor yeah. Sunday. Come on, let's give it up for our youth pastor, Pastor Latori and her husband helping her. Amen. We truly appreciate her. Don't forget, this Sunday morning's offering is going to youth pastor and her husband. Amen. God, because they have been a blessing to the youth and they work so hard every day, every day, every day. So we ask all of the young people that's 21 and younger. Yeah, 21 and younger. If you're younger than 21, we're asking you to give $10. And if you are 22, I guess, and up, $25. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My children, all of them, we gave them some of that stimulus money today. we gave all of our children some of that stimulus money. They was looking for it too, y'all. We gave them some of that stimulus money. And they said, Dad, this part I'm giving to you, Pastor. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. And I know some of y'all ain't gonna let my son, baby Jay, Jeremiah, outdo y'all. He told me, he said, the Lord told him, come on, Jeremiah, my son Jeremiah. He said, the Lord told me to give her $30. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on. I know you're not gonna let Jay is what? 12? He's 12 years old. So now you know he don't put the pressure on me, y'all. He don't put the pressure on Pastor G. I can't let him outdo me. So I'm gonna give more than 30. Hallelujah. Because baby Jay, 12 years old, said the Lord, and I like that part. He said the Lord. Hallelujah. Train up a child in the way that they should go. When they're old, they won't depart. He said the Lord told him to give Pastor Latori $30. Man. So we're asking you to please. We want to be a blessing to the Wilders family. Amen. And don't forget, Pastor Demetrius Short. Amen. Pastor Demetrius Short will be preaching, teaching Sunday morning. Somebody give it up for Elder Short. I don't know if he's on here watching or not. Amen. He probably sleeps somewhere. He's always busy working. So he probably knocked out somewhere. But amen. But Sunday is Youth Sunday. We're going to be honoring our youth pastor. She's taking a break. She won't be preaching this Sunday. She'll be preaching next month. Amen. Next third Sunday in May, she'll be preaching, but she's not preaching. But Pastor Demetrius Short will be at our youth praise team. We'll be singing praise and worship. So we are excited. That is all of our announcements. Amen. We're so glad to see all of you. We thank you for spending this time with us today. We are just so thankful. We pray that word was a blessing to you. We pray that word was a blessing to you. Tell somebody, share that word.
Yes.
Share that word. Let people know we're on our YouTube. It's also on our Facebook. They can get to our YouTube channel from our Facebook. So share. Invite people to church. Come on now. This is the best way. This is now the best time to invite people to church. They can sit right at home. Come on. They don't have to drive. They can sit right at home. Amen. That they are can come to church. All right. Lady Johnson said that Bishop Johnson said he's going to follow Jeremiah with 30. I'm telling you, Jeremiah is putting the pressure on us older people. Jeremiah has upped the young people. Come on, I know I got some young people out there. You ain't gonna let Jeremiah, you give your 10 and Jeremiah's giving 30 Sunday. Come on, glory. Come on, amen. But be in prayer. If you can give more than 30, if you can give more than 50, you cannot bless Pastor Latour and her husband enough. If you, especially you got children at church, especially if your young people is a part of the youth, I cannot pay her enough. My children has grown so much from her leadership, her husband, and their whole team. If you're on the youth board team, they have been growing from you. Amen. Sister Jennifer with the young adults, Amber, Gooch, and Sister Sampson, and Mother Stevenson, and Mother Howard with the children. Who else?
Brother Chris Austin
and Sister Christina, Brother Jonathan Austin, Sister Atiana, the Crudups, all those people that works with the youth. I'm telling you, we can't pay youth pastor enough. Amen. Amen. So we thank God for them. So this is all that we're doing. We're going to let our lovely wife end us in prayer. Amen. Somebody give it up for my wonderful wife, y'all. I'm telling you, I've been enjoying this time. I'm trying to get that sixth baby out of her, y'all. Hallelujah. Ooh, I felt that one. Come on. Don't lean over. Hallelujah. I've been trying to get that sixth baby. Somebody type in, we want number six. Come on. Come on. Somebody type in number six. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. If y'all want us to have another baby, say another baby, Pastor. Come on. The Bible told us to be fruitful and multiply. Hallelujah. She said no, y'all. She said no. Okay. And nobody typed it in, too, so they got your back.
Thank you.
They got your back, baby. Nobody typed in. They wanted baby number six. Oh my goodness. Amen. So at this time, amen. If you are next to somebody, amen. You're not afraid to grab their hand. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So remember the Bishop Johnson. Remember Lady Ruth Johnson. Please remember them and their grieving. Please remember them. And just remember your church family as a whole. And I cannot wait till we get back to church, y'all. I can't wait till we get back on one accord.
Thank you.
I can't wait. All right, let's pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this gathering once again. We thank you for the powerful word that went forth, Lord. Let it seep into our hearts, Lord. Let it set in our hearts, Lord, that we might not sin against thee,
yes,
O God. Lord, help us to remember to forget those things that are behind us, Lord, and move from pain to power, O God. Help us to remember everything that was said. Help us to remember and research every scripture that was given,
God.
Lord. Help us to grow up in you, O God. And we just thank you for the victory right now. Touch everyone that has tuned in via conference call. Touch everyone that has tuned in through YouTube, Lord.
Yes,
touch
God.
Those that are going to watch this even after live, Lord. We just thank you for the difference in our lives that you're making, Lord.
Yes, God.
We thank you for your word, Lord.
Glory
continue
to
help us, Lord, to grow each and every day until we assemble again, Lord. And we just thank you for the victory. Victory over unforgiveness, Lord.
Yes, God.
Victory over bitterness, Lord. Mm. We thank you for victory over hiding, Lord.
Mm.
Victory over hoarding, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you for all things in Jesus' name. And it is so.
Mm-hmm.
And it is done. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. All right. Sister Tanae said she won number six. Deacon Master said, you ask for six, you may get seven. Yes. We may have twins again.
Yes.
God bless y'all. Love y'all. Love y'all. Thank y'all. Thank everybody for chiming on. Thank you, my sister. My sister's on here. Tanae, my sister. Thank you. Thank everybody.
Love
Thank
y'all.
Everybody for chiming on. God bless. Thank you, Sister Hope, for that great words. She said, Pastor G. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. God is going to free us.
Yes.
He's freeing me. He's freeing me. We all being freed together.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He's freeing all of us together.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We love y'all.
Love you.
Are there any questions? Amen. Maybe somebody might have a question. I don't know. For those that want to chime off, you can chime off. But if somebody got a question, I'll try to answer a question if I can. Amen. Amen. Does anybody got any questions? Hallelujah. Maybe one Wednesday, I just have a Bible class with questions. Amen. Questions. Glory to God. Amen. Maybe I pray on that. We may have a Wednesday night where we just have a Q&A. just talking. Whatever questions you have, amen, we'll maybe be able to answer them. If we don't, we'll get back with you the next week with it. Because I don't know everything. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I may have to study and read and do some research. Amen. So, amen. But if you don't have any questions, amen. We're so, what would their names be? Hallelujah.
Oh my gosh.
Corona and and COVID. Amen. Corona, their names would be Corona and COVID. There'd be Corona and COVID would be their names. Hallelujah. No. Hallelujah. No. I don't know what their names would be. If they're boys, I would maybe name them Greg is junior, Greg number two, and Greg number three if they're boys. Hallelujah. But if they're girls, we'll name them Corona and COVID. Yeah, we'll name them Corona and COVID. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. Corona Johnson, COVID Johnson. No. Hallelujah. No, Deacon Manson, you're wrong. Deacon Manson, yeah. First they're going to get you for that one. Thank you, Stephanie Hope. That's right. Corona and COVID Johnson. We never shall forget this day. No. They will be a reminder what God brought us through. Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. No. Come on in here. Oh, don't get shot. Don't be getting shot. Hallelujah. Thank y'all for staying on with us, y'all. We have nothing else to do. We're gonna watch movies. We're gonna have Bible class. We're gonna have Saints meeting all week long, talking with the children, meeting with the children. So we have nothing to do but spend some time with the church family. Amen. But we are so thankful for all of y'all. We love y'all. Yes. We love y'all too. We love y'all. Deacon Manson said he had to do it. I know. And she gonna get you, Dick. She gonna get you. She gonna get you. Amen. But amen. Somebody type in some things. What y'all been doing for fun? Give us some ideas over here. Type in, Jerry said, you got me over here dying. hey, y'all type in some things. Let's do some chat. What are y'all doing for fun? And then maybe you can type in some things that we've been doing for fun. Hey, amen. What y'all been doing for fun at y'all house? Then maybe we can implement, and then maybe we can give y'all some things to implement. Hey, amen. What have y'all been doing during this quarantine for fun? Come on, somebody. Who's on here? Who's on here? What have your family been doing? One thing that we've been doing, believe it or not, we went to the lake. We went to Percy Priest Lake, and then we're talking about going back tomorrow, and it wasn't a lot of people there at all. It was only like 3 or 4 people there. So we have been going to the lake. We've been playing kickball, y'all. Pastor G been playing a lot of kickball. Amen. Amen. Pastor G's been playing a lot of kickball with the kids. Somebody, we're doing virtual family feud on Sunday on Zoom. Amen. Good idea. Love that. Thank you, Trustee Oliver. Love that. Amen. We've been doing a lot of stuff outside with the kids. What else? What else y'all been doing for fun out there? Come on. Come on. Somebody type in some things that we've been doing for fun. And also one thing we've been doing since it's seven of us. We've been allowing each person to choose a movie each night, whenever we do. We don't watch a movie every night, but when we do, we take turns and we let everybody pick a movie that they like to watch. So I think it's my wife's turn. So the next time we watch a movie, we let everybody get a turn, and we all get popcorn and we all get our juice and get all our snacks together.
Let's go, Colonels.
And Colonels, yes, yes, Colonels. We will see you next week. Okay, we still got some of that popcorn we got last week. So we went to Colonel's and got some popcorn. Amen. So come on. I fed Corey applesauce airplane style. Amen. that's Brother Ken. Okay. What else y'all been doing for fun out there, OCT? What else y'all been doing for fun out there? We just hanging on here. I wonder who that Lee is. Who? Is that Leland? Is that Lee? It says Lee. Is that Leland on here? She looks like you're working on three or four, bro. Hey. Oh, Lord, mercy. Lord, all right. Sister Lita said we made personal biscuit pizzas.
Ooh.
How? Explain that.
Smash out the biscuit and make
it and roll it? Oh, okay. You what guys should watch Designated Survivor Netflix. Okay. All right. Also, somebody told me that is a movie on YouTube called The Chosen. The Chosen. We're going to watch that. That's going to be my next movie. It's about Jesus, and they say it's really good. It's called The Chosen. Baby, type that in, baby. It's on YouTube, The Chosen. And it has 8 episodes. You have to hear that. It's called The Chosen. Amen. So we won't kill. We won't have to kill him. Kim will kill me. Hey, that won't happen, Kim. Yeah. So, All right. So, yeah. So, getting some sunshine outside. A lot. Sister Goodlow. All right. What are y'all doing to keep the weight off? Come on. Somebody talk to me. Come on. Talk to me. What are you doing to keep your pounds off? I wish Elder Short was on here. Me and Elder Short is thinking about doing a YouTube. Live YouTube on a Sunday around about 5 p.m. a workout at the church. Doing a workout, you come on and you have your children, your kids in the living room. So me and Elder Short, we're working on that. Jerry said nothing. Come on, Doc. Come on. No. That's not the answer I need, Trustee Oliver. That is not the answer I need. What are we doing to keep this weight off? Deacon Manson said eating right. That's right. What are some meals are you cooking to lose the weight or to keep these pounds off? Me and Elder Short is thinking about doing a... He's rocking my COVID body. Oh, my goodness. Man, you're a clown. You're a nutcase. Me and Elder Short is thinking about doing a workout, 30-minute workout. I think we're going to start it at 5 p.m. We'll let you know what Sunday. We're thinking about doing it maybe once or twice a month on a Sunday. And a 30-minute workout, it may be an hour. We'll see. But probably no. My wife said 30. We'll do a 30-minute workout and on a Sunday. It's going to be on a Sunday. It's coming soon. Be looking forward to that. It's coming soon. We're going to do it at the church on the stage. We'll move all that stuff off the stage, and we're going to have some workout gear, and we'll have a couple of our children. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a gym class or aerobics, something. Yeah, gym class at the church on a Sunday at 5 p.m. We'll let you know what Sunday. He said, working in the kitchen inside joke. Is that working or twerking? Brother Ken Dowdell, is that twerking? Is that twerking in the kitchen or working in the kitchen? I think you said twerking. Oh, doing side hustle with all the walking. Oh, she said, this is Charnice. Oh, so you twerking now. Woo, the Saints, the backslid. Saints, the backslid, Lord. I'm coming over there with some oils, Sister Charnice. You twerking in the kitchen? Lord. Lord, we twerking now. Put your hand on the screen, Sister Charnice. Put your hand on the screen, Sister Charnice. Come on. I'm going to pray for you. Yeah, my hand is on your head right now in the name of Jesus. Come on. Come on. We praying for you, Sister Charnice. What else y'all doing to keep the weight off? We're going to be on here for about 2 more minutes. 8 o'clock. We got 2 minutes. We're going to chime off. 2 minutes. It said, did y'all watch the Clark Sisters? Yes. Loved it. How you feel? Loved it. I guess that's it. I guess I spelled that right. Yes. Loved it, Dr. Oliver. Yes. Yes. Yes, I wish that thing could have went for about another 2 hours or so. Hey, Lee said, what about a 15-minute workout to start? No. if that's Leland, is that you? Tell me, Lee. We just got Lee on here. Is that Leland? Say yes.
Glory.
Is that you, Lee? Leland, Deacon Leland, is that you? We're doing 30 minutes. We're not doing a 15-minute workout. Come on. You can take a break. We're going to have some breaks in there. We're going to do some breaks. Come on now. You've been sitting at home. We've been sitting at home, eating and doing nothing. No, we're going to work out for 30 minutes. What Sunday? Is this third Sunday? We may start it the first Sunday in May. I get with Pastor Short, and we probably gonna launch this thing first Sunday in May. Amen. Heard of it, but haven't seen it. Yeah. If you have not seen the Clark Sisters movie, please watch it. Please watch the Clark Sisters movie. Is really good. Did not know they went through all of that.
Yes.
See, that's another thing. We see people on the outside. Mm-hmm. We see the fame. We see the money. But you don't see what they had to go through. The Clark Sisters, what they had to go through to get that. So, yes, but it was a great movie. Great movie. So, love the Clark Sisters. But who in the whole world? Who in the world is the lost? Yeah, I didn't know they had Denise. I didn't know who Denise was either.
Yeah.
But she's now a pastor.
Yeah.
And working on her doctor's degree. Mm-hmm. So the Lord is blessing her. The Lord is using her. So so this Leland. Amen. Oh yes, the Jordan. Michael Jordan documentary. Yeah. And the documentary, yeah, Jordan's is coming out this Sunday, 8 p.m. I will be at my mom's and dad's house, y'all. Yes, gonna watch that with Mackenzie, my dad, and my mom, and my wife, my children. Yes, Michael Jordan, Sunday at 8 o'clock. That's gonna be a good show to watch. Amen. Yes, that's gonna be a good show. But we want you to get ready. I'm gonna get with Elder Short, and I'm gonna see, can we launch this workout the first Sunday in May at 5 p.m. We'll try to get a flyer out. We'll try to get it. And we're gonna have the stage at the church. So hopefully, Brother Ken, hope you watch this, Brother Ken. You can help us out with the camera. But we're gonna get going because we got to get some of this weight off of us. Amen. Amen. So we want y'all to come on. Make your living room, move those couches out the way, and make it a family event. We want your children to be a part of this workout, not just the adults, but this is for the whole family. Get them some gear, get them some shorts, get them, you know, some workout gear. We're gonna try to launch this thing first Sunday in May. I will confirm that this Sunday, but we're gonna work it out. We're gonna work out together as a church. Amen. Amen. We're gonna work together out as a community. So we're gonna do that together. So we are excited. But we're about to chime off. Thank y'all for hanging to us to 8 o'clock. We love all of you.
Amen.
We miss you.
Yes.
But we're looking forward to Sunday, and we may be fasting some next week, y'all.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, we may be fasting some. So we're gonna be in prayer about that. But we want to get back. But love y'all. God bless, and we'll see you, Lord's will, Sunday. God bless y'all. God bless.